Beloved, welcome back to the shop. We have a very, very special unboxing. This happens about once a year and has for several years now. This box is from England and has something, well, I don't know exactly what it is, but it's gonna be amazing, and I thought we would do an unboxing together. Because, well, because it's fun. We'll be using the Microtech. Love this knife for the unboxing. All right, shall we take a peek inside? The contents of this box is made by one of those very rare companies, the few remaining companies that are actually producing beautiful things that I fear won't be around very much longer. Maybe this is not what I was expecting. Well, that's unexpected. But I think the star of the show, oh, I think it is. Let's put this up on the toolbox. What in the world is this? Well, I know it's a Stirling engine, but this has a whole nother, what in the world is that? Is this a power generator? I think it's a power generator. If this is what I think it is, it's something that I have been wanting someone to invent for a long time, to be able to produce energy from a wood stove. What in the world is going on here? Well, it's very carefully packed. Something important in here. What is this? I am completely stymied here. There's a few more items. Let's unpack the other stuff. There are three other, what in the world is this? It's got a nail on it. It looks like a wick. Man, I am at a complete loss. Then we have a small measuring cup and a very tiny funnel. And very curiously, an AM/FM radio. This is a good one too, an emergency radio. There are instructions, I'm guessing. Hopefully there's something in here. The radio is really throwing me off here. I think I know where we might be going, but I'm not sure. Very quintessential English. Very nice. So what we have, I mean, we have a Stirling engine, obviously. The same ones that are running on my wood stove, but this one's completely different in that it has what looks to be a generator. Replacement O-ring, lubricating oils. What in the world? Okay, I'm gonna have to read this. Come here, Mama. Come on. Mama. Come here. Come on. Come on, you can come up. All right, I know exactly what it is. This is 91% isopropyl alcohol. Now this should be in your kit for cleaning wounds, but it's also very good for an emergency heater. So we are instructed to pour in 60 milliliters, whatever that is, somewhere around there. No more, because alcohol expands when it gets hot. We've got this beautiful this is a lamp, a heater. This is turned from aluminum. I'm not a machinist, but oh, there's the wick, the fiberglass wick. This is turned on a lathe, it appears to me, and then a cap, friction fit, pressed in, and then threaded. I mean, this is not an easy thing to make. This is a very a very nice item. So we'll pour the isopropyl. Now, careful when you're buying your isopropyl. It's got to be above 90% or so to burn. You'll see, be careful, you'll buy it sometimes, it'll be in the 70s, which is fine for disinfecting, but in my opinion, 91 is what you want, because that'll burn. You can light a match to it. Okay, so how this works, this fiberglass wick lays in there and curls on the bottom a little bit, and that will actually draw that isopropyl alcohol up into the top here, and very shortly, we should be able to light it. Down here on the bottom, we have a glass chimney that is lifts up so you can install the torch. That is very, very nice. Let's see if it lights. It should light. It's been in there for a couple minutes now. Oh, good grief. Should have engaged my safety squins. This little lantern is going to run for about 4 hours or so. And that chimney will keep that flame from going out. Now that's going to be heating up what they call, I think, a displacer. Imagine it, there's like a piston in here. And as that piston, as the air heats up and starts to travel upwards, it moves that air carries that displacer along. And then you have two graphite valves here. Now take all of this with a grain of salt, but how I understand it, as this, the heat goes up, it forces these up, which release some of that hot air continuing a cycle. And then once you reach a certain point, this will actually run on its own like a steam engine just from the heat of the, you could even put a candle down there. Whatever supply, heat supply you put down there should be fine. Once the crank starts turning, we've got this big flywheel with a O-ring on it, and that's going to turn, it's not ready to go yet. That's gonna turn a generator in here. This is basically just like you'd have in a dam. That's gonna produce the power out here, which is gonna charge the small appliance. So while that's heating up, let's check out a radio. I really appreciate the high quality radio as well. It's hard to find a good radio. This should be on your preparation list, beloved. You should have a terrestrial radio. AM, FM is shortwave if you can get it. When the internet goes down or when they shut it off, this will be our only way to get information apart from face to face. And not being sitting in the dark, not knowing what's going on, is terrible. So having a small radio that you can power with solar or rechargeable batteries is as important as a water filter, to me. Okay, so this is AM and FM. Oh, it's already ready to go. It's got the cable on it. So does that charge? Maybe I should be getting into things that I don't understand here. I should have left well enough alone. They had it all set up for me, and now I'm ruining everything. It looks like these are 3D printed dummy batteries. So you could take these out. I'm guessing you just put two AA's in there. So the power, the 100% of the power is going to be coming from the Stirling engine. There is no battery to this. So just simply, well, I'll wait till it heats up a little bit, but you plug that in there. What's this all about? What a beautiful red box. So these are, oh, and of course these headphones will allow us to go into Anne Frank mode, where we can record our diaries of oppression with a ballpoint pen. I think we're ready for the startup sequence. The candle's been on there for about 10 minutes, and this Stirling engine should run clockwise. And if we give this a spin, that flywheel should, look at that, there we go. Very cool, very cool. How cool is this? We are producing electricity right now with a little paraffin lamp. Now we're supposed to let this run for about 30 minutes to get some heat in it, and it will continue to spin faster and faster before we plug in the radio. But this is very exciting. I'm gonna have some requests for our friends over at Warp 5 who built this for me. I think that this is a great potential to be able to recharge on a wood stove or with a candle or a lantern is really cool. But I want this on the wood stove, if that's possible. And I would like it to have produced enough power that we could charge a phone or a flashlight or a AA battery as well. I don't know if that's possible with the Stirling, but if it is, man, let's make that happen. The Stirling's been running for about 15 minutes, but you all know I'm a petulant child and I can't wait for anything, so I'm gonna try this out right now. So, now we're gonna, since we're in my personal Faraday cage, we may struggle with getting a radio signal, but we'll give it a try. Okay, so there's no switch on the generator. Hear the current. So it is, it's running a little bit slow. So we're getting, it's alternating, it's not constant. That's what I'm guessing. Where's the tuning? One thing you can always depend upon with terrestrial radio is you will get the liars at NPR. Okay, here we go. It has been 40 minutes, and let's give the radio a test. Well, we're not going to get a station in here, but radio is definitely powered by the Stirling engine. I was thinking how much I'd like to see the same thing on a table or a wood stove version, where you could put right on the top of the wood stove like the Stirling fans. As I was thinking about that, that's probably not possible with the electronic generator in there. It probably would not stand up to the heat. And I was thinking, well, I wouldn't even mind having something that was remote that you could plug in and put away from the heat. But then again, you have to have the electrical connections. And one thing I have learned from having wood stoves, well, living with them my entire life, is wood stoves and electronics don't match or don't blend well. Whenever you put them in a wood stove, it happens. No matter how careful you are, it's easy to overfire a stove and they get it too hot. And that really messes up those circuit boards. And if you've had those and had to replace them, you know, that's just a no-go. Just a no-go. It just does not mix like oil and water. So I understand that. I don't know how you would do it, but it would be cool, would it not, to have something where you could use the heat from your wood stove to charge modern electronics, like really essential ones like batteries, flashlights, cell phones, that sort of thing. But this is very, very cool to have a little self-contained emergency generator with an emergency battery or radio. It's awesome. So thank you to Warp 5 for sending that out. They once a year they send me a box and always had something cool in it like this. And I'm not paid to do this. It's a quid pro quo. They do nice things for me. I do nice things for them. And I think it's cool. And I think a lot of you guys are interested in it as well. So I'll put a link to their website down below if you want to check it out. But these are handmade in England and they're beautiful. They're absolutely beautiful. And I really appreciate the craftsmanship and how unique and clever they are. Having this on your coffee table would be a very interesting conversation piece, would it not? May God bless you and your families. Please keep us in your prayers and we'll see you all on the next video.